فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So inshallah ta'ala, we're now going to start al-madhhab al-maliki, the Maliki madhhab. Before we go into the madhhab, we always start with at-ta'rifu bi imam al-madhhab. Who is the imam of this particular madhhab? Who is the imam of this particular madhhab? Malik ibn Anas. Imam Malik, who's the imam of this madhhab, is Abu Abdullah Malik ibn Anas ibn Malik ibn Abi Amir al-Asbahi al-Himyari al-Madani. And Imam Malik was born when the year was 93 Hijriah. And it's also said that he was born 94. And it's also said 97. And Imam Malik's birth, there's a strange story to it. That all of the people who have spoken about his biography have mentioned. They mentioned, and this is all of the narrators, all of the tarajim, all of the biography, everyone who spoke about his biography mentioned this. That his mother was pregnant for 4 years, carrying him. And Imam Malik was in the womb of his mother for 4 years. This is what all of the biography mentioned. They state this. And Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala the reality to it. And Imam Malik is Imam fi Sunnah. He's an Imam in the Sunnah. Imam in Hadith. Imam in Fiqh. The ulama have unanimously agreed upon ala jalalatihi, in his honor and his dignity. And they have unanimously agreed upon his imamah. And they've also all agreed upon, unanimously, that al-imam Malik's khilaf is mu'tamar. That his disagreement is considered. That we'll take it into consideration. Al-imam Malik rahimahullah, he inherited a great portion of fiqh from the scholars of Medina. There was no imam, or there's no individual in the city of Medina after the tabi'een more greater, more knowledgeable than Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala. Every imam have all agreed upon. Ittafaqat kalimatul ulama. The ulama's speeches, all of them, is in all in agreement. Ala thana'i ala Imam Malik. The praising of Imam Malik. Here is Hamad ibn Zayd. When it came to him that Imam Malik rahimahullah, he died. And he passed away. Salat dumu'uh, his tears poured from his eyes. This is Hamad ibn Zayd. And then he said, Yarhamullahu, may Allah bestow mercy upon Aba Abdullah Imam Malik. لَقَدْ كَانَ مِنَ الدِّينِ بِمَا كَانَ. He was on a high level in the religion. He was on a high status in regards to the affairs of the religion. Abu Khaythamah Zuhayr ibn Harbin narrated this in his Tariq al-Kabir, Ibn Adi in his Kitab al-Kamil, Al-Khalili in his Kitab al-Irshad, Ibn Abdul Barr in his Kitab al-Intiqa, and also in his Kitab al-Tabhid. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said, إِذَا ذُكِرَ الْعُلَمَاء فَمَالِكٌ النَّجْمُ فَمَالِكٌ النَّجْمُ. If ulama are mentioned, the Imam Malik is the star. He is the star of all of the ulama. He also said about himself, Imam Shafi'i said, مَا أَحَدٌ أَمَنَّ عَلَيَّ مِنْ مَالِكٍ أَنِسٍ. No one has done more favor for me than Imam Malik. He also said, Malik ibn Anas mu'allimi. Malik ibn Anas is my teacher. وَعَنْهُ أَخَذْتُ الْعِلْمِ. And from him I took knowledge from. This is what? Praise. He's my teacher. And I took knowledge from him. AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi. He said, أَئِمَّةُ النَّاسِ فِي زَمَانِهِمْ أَرْبَعَ. The أَئِمَّة of the people of their time was four. There were four Imams of their time. Sufyan al-Thawri in Kufa. For the people of Kufa, their Imam was Sufyan al-Thawri. وَمَالِكٌ and Imam Malik bin Hijaz. And Imam Malik was the alim of the people of Hijaz. وَالْأَوْزَاعِيُّ بِالشَّامِ and Imam al-Awza'i, he was a scholar of the people of Sham. وَحَمَّاد ibn Zayd bin Basra. And Hamad ibn Zayd was the scholar of the people of Basra. AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi, he said, do you guys know who AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi is? AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi was the man who commanded Shafi'i to write the Kitab al-Risala. And Shafi'i authored the Kitab al-Risala because of the command of his teacher, AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi. AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi is from the shuyukh of Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i. AbdulRahman ibn Mahdi said, ما رأيت I never saw أعقل من مالك بن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه وارضاه. Said I never saw anyone more smarter, more intellectual than Imam Malik. Than Imam Malik. All of those statements that I mentioned, you can find them in the Kitab al-Intiqab by Ibn Abd al-Barr and his Kitab al-Tamhid. You can also find it in AbdulRahman ibn Abi Hatim's Kitab al-Jarh wa al-Ta'dil, Ibn Adil's Kitab al-Kamil, Al-Harawi's Kitab al-Dhamm al-Kalami wa Ahli. You can find it there, inshaAllah ta'ala. It was said to Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah. Somebody came to Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and they said to him, Ya Aba Abdullah, or Abu Abdullah, Rajulun yuridu an yahfadha haditha rajulin wahidin bi'aynihi. There's one person who just wants to memorize one individual's narrations. They don't want to memorize all that. They just want to, one scholar, they just want to stick with his narrations and they want to take all his hadiths. رَجُلٌ يُرِيدُ أَن يَحْفَظَ حَدِيثَ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ بِعَيْنِهِ. He specifically wants to read one particular person's narration. بِحَدِيثِ مَنْ تَرَى لَهُ. Whose narration do you see that he should go for? I mean, which person do you think he should just sit and memorize all these ahadith? Now, of course, this question, it means a person whose ahadith are authentic, number one. A person whose narrations are jami', comprehensive, meaning if you memorize all these narrations, you have a great portion in the religion. So that's the person he's asking for, right? And a person who's imam, who's reliable, of course. Ahmed said, يَحْفَظُ حَدِيثَ مَالِكِ. Let him memorize the ahadith of Imam Malik. Ibn Abd al-Barr mentions that in his Kitab al-Intiqa, Ibn Abi Hatim Kitab Jarh al-Ta'dil. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi said about Imam Malik, he said, Shaykh al-Islam, Hujjat al-Ummah, Imam Dar al-Hijrah. That's his description, he said. He said he's Shaykh al-Islam. He is Hujjat al-Ummah. He is the Hujjah and the proof of this Ummah. He is Imam Dar al-Hijrah. He's the Imam of Medina. Dar al-Hijrah is the place that the Prophet came to after he left Mecca. And Imam al-Dhahabi also said, he said, وَطَلَبَ مَالِكٌ الْعِلْمِ وَطَلَبَ مَالِكٌ الْعِلْمِ. And Imam Malik sought knowledge. وَهُوَ ابْنُ بِضْ عَشَرَةَ سَنَةً. And he was only in his teens, between 13 to 19. وتأهل للفتية. And an Imam Malik, this is Dhahabi saying this, and he became a person who was permitted to give fatwa. He had the rights, he had the instruments, he had the knowledge, he had the understanding, he had the capability. ما معنى تأهل للفتية? He was the right individual to do what? Fatwa. وجلس للإفادة. He sat down to benefit. وَلَهُ إِحْدَى وَعِشْرُونَ سَنَةً. And he was only 21 years of age. Imam Malik was how much? How old was he? He was only 21 years of age. And he was what? He was mu'ahal. He had the rights, he was permitted to give fatwa. And he was permitted to sit down and to benefit the people. He was allowed to. Who? Al-Imam Malik, rahimahullah. Hey, Abu. What are you? Go, Abu Ashar. This is the breaker, it's finished.
Abu.
Hey, Abu Bayhada. Go. وتأهل للفتيا وجلس للإفادة وله 21 سنة. ها. هيك قال أبو بس بح قال ما تي. أبو بح. هاي هذا قبوا هذا قبوا. بق. وتأهل للفتيا. He was the right candidate to give fatwa. وجلس للإفادة. He sat down to benefit. وله إحدى وعشرون سنة. And he was what? 21 years of age. Now pay attention. He said about himself, he's 21 years of age. But what did he say? ما جلست. I never sat down to speak or to give fatwa or to answer question. إِلَّا بَعْدَ أَنْ شَهِدَ لِي سَبْعُونَ Until I was permitted by 70 scholars from the scholars of the Ummah of that time, the scholars of Medina, they said to me, yes, no problem, yes, 70 ulama gave him. Dahabi went on to say it, in Sir Alam al-Nubala, first volume, page 55, he says, وَحَدَّتَ عَنْهُ جَمَاعَةٌ Many scholars, many individuals narrated from him. وَهُوَ حَيٌّ شَابٌ طَرِيٌّ He was a young chap. وَقَصَدَهُ طَلَبَةُ الْعِلْمِ مِنَ الْآفَاقِ فِي آخِرِ دَوْلَةِ أَبِي جَعْفَرِ الْمَنْصُورِ وَمَا بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ People intended, they intended to seek knowledge from him all over the world. From the time of Abi Ja'far al-Mansur's leadership, and after that, and it became more, Imam Malik became more busy, was dahamuhu alayhi fi khilafat al-Rashid wa ila ammat. The time of Harun al-Rashid, he became even more, what do you call it, busy. People occupied, people came, until he died, Imam Malik's students were leaving him. So here you take a benefit from it, which is a tanbih uridu an unabbiha, a point which I want to bring to your attention, which is, brothers, you can see Malik was young, he was 21. He was 21 years of age. And there are many people, due to lack of knowledge, they would think that age is what determines whether knowledge should be taken from a person. And that is incorrect. It's wrong. There are many ulama who were very young in age. ولذلك the narrations that you see where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say that the hour will strike if knowledge is sought عند الأصاغر when it's taken from the youngsters, the young ones. Many thought that this particularly, specifically means anyone whose age is young. If knowledge is sought from him, you shouldn't, or knowledge shouldn't be sought from him. Sah? And those narrations, they don't mean that. What they mean, al-asagir, mentioned by Ibn Abdul Barr in his kitab Jami' Bayani al-Ilmi wa Fadli from Abdullah ibn Mubarak, that the word asagir means what? It means the innovators. The innovators. The mubtadi', he's considered asagir. He's not a kabir, he's not somebody who's big in the eyes of Ahlul Sunnah. They belittle them. A kabir is anybody who's what? Do you know what a kabir is? A kabir is anybody who has knowledge and his knowledge is in line with those who are greater than him in knowledge. If a person's statement does not exit, it doesn't leave the kalam of the kibar ulama of our time. His kalam is in line with the kalam of Sheikh Ibn Baz. His kalam is in line with the kalam of Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani. Is in line with Sheikh Muhammad Salih Uthaymeen. Then we'll say this individual, if he's teaching knowledge that's in line with these, and in line with Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, and in line with the kalam of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, and Ibn al-Qayyim, and Ibn Rajab, and Ibn al-Kathir, and other than them, then this individual, he is kabir, he is somebody, he's considered from the akabir, wa in qalla sinnuh, and wa in sawra sinnuh, even if his age is little. And as the poet said, wa kam min sagheerin la hadathu inayatun fahtajat ilayhi al-akabiru. Wa kam min sagheerin, how many people were young, la hadathu inayatun min Allahi fahtajat ilayhi al-akabiru. How many people were young in age, but the elders were in need of them. They came and they took knowledge from them. So when we say a person is young and we're not going to take knowledge from him, is when he is either an innovator or that individual's knowledge is not in line with what? The ulama. He's not in line with them. He's speaking from his own whims and desires. You can see Malik ibn Anas here is speaking when he's a shabun tariyun, young. He's a shab and he's very young. And you all know Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab authored his Kitab al-Tawheed and he was only 25 years of age. Scholars who are now beards are white, Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh Abdul Aziz Ali Sheikh Mufti Saudiya, the Mufti, Ibn Baz, Sheikh Abdullah ibn Humayd, Sheikh Salih al-Luhaydan and others. They all explain Kitab al-Tawheed. And the author was 25 years of age. Sah? The author who wrote it was 25 years of age. The scholars that are reading it now are old in age. Sahih? Because the issue is that for them it is not the number. It's the knowledge and the mind on this individual. And how many people ask, كَبِيرٌ فِي السِّنِّي صَغِيرٌ فِي الْعِلْمِ. He's old in age. He's old in age. But he's young in what do you call it? He's young in knowledge. فَلَا يُلْتَفُتُ إِلَيْهِ. No one's going to say, because your age is big and your beard is white, we're going to take knowledge from you. صح? No. وَلِذَلِكَ. That's why sometimes this concept gets pushed by so-and-so, he's young. Who gave him tazkiyah? Who gave him a tazkiyah? And this is also another problem. Qadiyya of age, which is being taken incorrectly and misunderstood incorrectly. And the other issue is the concept of what? A tazkiyah. Who praised you from the ulama? The tazkiyah according to the ulama is of two types. There's one called tazkiyah to a'yan and tazkiyah to al-ilm. Tazkiyah to a'yan means what? Tazkiyah to a'yan means you as an individual, per se, AbdulRahman Hassan, you as an individual, you get a tazkiyah from a sheikh. He gives you by name, Fulan ibn Fulan. The person is being praised by a sheikh, a scholar praising him by name. The scholar says, Fulan yu'khadu anhu al-ilm. This person, knowledge is sought from him, knowledge is taken from him. Idrusu ala fulani, go and take knowledge from this person. Khudu anhu, take from him. This is the highest of levels. It's called daraja aliyah fi tazkiyah. It's a high level of praise, no doubt. Second one is tazkiyatul ilm. Tazkiyatul ilm means you may not be praised by a scholar. No scholar has actually praised you. Okay? And no scholar has actually said anything in praise of you. But what is it that praises you here? Your own knowledge. When this person is looked at, when this person is observed, when this person is looked at, his knowledge is in accordance to the Kitab and the Sunnah. وَلَا يُخَالِفُ الْعُلَمَاءِ الْأَكَابِرِ. He's not in a position to the kalam of the kibar. He's in line with the ulama. Again, he's in line with Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz. He's in line with Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, Sheikh al-Nasir, rahimahumullahu jami'an. Okay? He's in line with the ulama, Ibn Kathir and Dhahabi and Ibn Rajab and Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn al-Qayyim. He's in line with the salaf of hadhihi al-Ummah. He's in line with the scholars. He doesn't leave their kalam. He doesn't have his own opinions that he comes in. He does taqrirat, he affirms ما يقرره علماء السنة. He affirms what the ulama of the sunnah affirm. This individual will say, when we look at him, even if we don't have no ulama that praised him, زكاه علمه. His knowledge has now praised him. His knowledge has praised him, this individual. And it should be sought from him, and knowledge should be taken from him. And he's of benefit for the people. And anybody who stands in the way of his and stops him from teaching, or stops that in the, or says that this person's knowledge should not be sought from him, he is a qati'u tariq. He's blocking the ummah from benefiting from that which is beneficial for them. People sometimes live in countries where this is the best person that they have. This is the best that they have. This is the best person they have. He's one strong student of knowledge. He's again in line with the kalam of the ulama. He's kitab and sunnah. He's aqidah sahiha salima. Are you with me, brothers? And people say we won't take knowledge from him. Why? Because no scholar praised him. Just because of that. That's incorrect. Because he's been praised by what? By his knowledge. He has been praised. What is it that praised him? His knowledge praised him. His knowledge praised him. Naam. And Imam Malik rahimahullah. So that was a fa'idah that we need to take on board. And Imam Malik rahimahullah, he's, as I said, he's a sahib al-sunnah. He's an imam in sunnah. And the meaning by the word sunnah is aqidah here, of course. Okay? The intent by the word sunnah عند المتقدمين, by the early generation of scholars, is that it's meant by aqidah. He was an imam in aqidah. Like, for example, an Imam Malik used to say, لَيْسَ الْجِدَالُ فِي الدِّينِ بِالشَّيْءٍ. Argumentation and debates are not in the religion whatsoever. There's no place in the deen. Meaning he meant by debating with Ahlul Bid'ah and consistently argumentation with them. This is not from the religion. He also used to say, أَهْلُ الْأَهْوَاءِ بِئْسَ الْقَوْمِ لَا يُسَلَّمُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَاعْتِزَالُهُمْ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ. And Imam Malik used to say, the people of innovation are the worst of people. Salam should not be given to them. They shouldn't be greeted. One should not say to them, assalamu alaikum. Shouldn't. وَاَعْتِزَالُهُمْ. And they boycotted and left. أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ is more beloved to me. To leave their gatherings and to leave their surroundings and to stay away from them is more beloved to me. Allahu Akbar. And Imam Malik, at his time, he was saying that. He even went to the level of saying, لَا يَنْبَغِ الْإِقَامَةُ فِي أَرْضٍ. It is not permissible to reside in a land, يَكُونُ الْعَمَلُ فِيهَا بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ, which the people, what they are doing is in clear-cut opposition to the truth. وَالسَّبُّ لِلسَّلَفِ, and the salaf are insulted as well. And the salaf are what? Insulted. No one should reside in a land, Imam Malik is saying this, where the deen is being opposed, and the haqq is being opposed, and the salaf are being insulted 24/7. You shouldn't be in a land like that. Are you with me, brothers? So what would he see? What would he say if he saw us and in the land and the place that we're in? So this is how much it meant to him, salaf. Those who insult the salaf, who say something about the salaf, Imam Malik to him was big. You may now see a person who insults the salaf and he's still praised. Are you with me, brothers? He insults the salaf and he's still praised. People are praising him. They're bigging him up. They're pushing him up. Are you there? Even belittle the works of the salaf. Like one man who recently died. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. He said reading the books of the salaf will dry your heart. It will, you will find from reading the works of the salaf in the aqidah, it will just what? Qaswatul qalb. It will make your heart, it will harden your heart. He's referring to the books by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, his Usul al-Sunnah and others. Recently when he died, one of the figureheads of this country, who people look up to and they call him Shaykh and Fulan and Alan, He wrote an article in praise of him. The point is, a salaf, and a'imma to salaf's hardship and their work, Kitab Khalq Afa'al al-Ibad, which Bukhari wrote in the situation he wrote it, and Imam Ahmed's Kitab Usul al-Sunnah, at the time he wrote it, in the way he wrote it, and Imam Ibn Bahali's Kitab al-Sharh al-Sunnah, at the time he wrote it, and the situation he wrote it. All of that, no consideration is given to that. Are you with me? And the way it's been spoken against. Are you there, brothers? But this individual who's today alive, his statements is respected and it's looked after. He don't say anything about him. His honor. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And Imam Malik said, Al-Qur'an kalamullah. The Qur'an is what? The speech of who? It's the speech of Allah. Look at his aqidah. Imam fi sunnah. The Qur'an is the speech of Allah. He also said, Man qala al-Qur'an makhlukun. Look at the salaf, how they're harsh they were when it came to consequences of actions. What did he say? Man qala al-Qur'an makhluq. Anyone who says the Qur'an is created, yuja'u darban wa yuhbasu hatta yatub. He's beaten and he's lashed. And he's in prison until he repents. And Imam al-Jubri brings it in his Kitab al-Sharia. The salaf, they had this. But the person who does this is who? Everybody? No, the leader does this. The Muslim leader, he does this. He takes it on himself, the leader, to take this person, to imprison them, to lash them. Because the religion is going to be forsaken. And Imam Malik also said, Allahu fi sama, Allah is above his throne. And Imam Malik rahimahullah said, Allah is what? Fi sama. He said that. Abdullah ibn Ahmad narrated this in his Kitab al-Sunnah. Okay, Al-Ajurri in Kitab al-Sharia. And Ibn Abdul Barr in Kitab al-Tamheed. So anybody who says to you, Ana Malikiyul Madhab, I'm a Maliki in Madhab, and he says to you, I'm an Ash'ari in Aqidah, then he opposes the Imam he follows. Can't be. And look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the four Imams. Each and every one of them observed them. What do they say to you? Pay attention. They will say to you, Fil Furu'i, I'm a Hanafi. Fil Usuli, I'm a Maturidi. Fi Suluk, I'm a Naqshbandi. I'm a Brelwi, whatever. Huh? Are you with me, brothers? Pay attention to this. Allah has protected their tongues with their own mouths to say that I am a Hanafi, khalas. And he means that the Hanafiyyah is a Maturidiyah. He knows it's not. He knows an Imam Ahmad, Imam Abu Hanif wasn't a Maturidi. He knows that an Imam Malik was not an Ash'ari. So he will say to you, Ash'ariyun fil Usuli, Malikiyun fil Furu'i. Are you with me? Allah has protected these Imams, these four Imams, they were upon Aqidat Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Are you there, brothers? They were upon Aqidat Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Does that make sense, brothers?